have a dream of becoming a church. What is the church of the poor? PCP2 has a beautiful section on this. And I would like to summarize it. A church of the poor is where the rich and the poor live evangelical poverty and place riches at the service of God's kingdom. And again you ask, what is evangelical poverty? That poverty which is a disposition that Bishop Ambo explained. Blessed are the poor. There are two versions of that. Matthew says, blessed are the poor in spirit. Luke says, blessed are the poor. Is there a difference? There's a certain difference. Blessed are the poor speaks about the radicality of the gospel. Entry into the gospel. Blessed are the poor in spirit, that rich man who was sad. Sad because, according to Bishop Ambo, he began to realize something more than his riches, that things that seem to have. The riches that Jesus can give. And Jesus loved him because this man, rich man, became sad. He realized that this man was worthy of God's love, and Jesus loved him. That is poor in spirit, poor poverty. Church of the poor is where the rich are not so rich as not to be able to give. Where the poor are not so poor as not to be able to give, to receive, in prayer. Where the rich are not so rich as to be able not to receive, and the poor are not so poor as not to be able to give. That's the church of the poor, where the rich are in active solidarity with the poor, where they have the richest place at the service of the reign of God, which is a reign of justice. And when we talk about justice in the Philippines, it's about social justice. Social justice, where every man, every woman, every child exercise or live the gospel of justice, and the government helps it to do that. Social justice, where the care of the whole church is tilted towards the poor. And that's the reason why in every diocese where I have been, go out, go forth, go down among the poor, to the villages. Make sure that people see in your schedule that your schedule is filled with visits to the barrios. And if you are talking about basic ecclesial communities or GKA, God Almighty Christ, the most important time for them is evening time. Because that is the time when they come home from work, come home from the farms. And that is the time when you can gather them for forming the basic ecclesial communities. And if you do not have that time, I ask, what is your ministry for? You must have time. Time for the poor, time for the farmers, time for the slum dwellers. And you can have that time if you visit them and be with them in the evenings. Your time as a priest is 24 hours a day for the people. Whether it's the middle of the night when a sick call comes, you do not ask, grab it up. You're going to pray for them. Where there is no ambition for power, for comfort, go out of your comfort zone, says Pope Francis. Go out of your comfort zone. Sisters and priests, go out of your comfort zone. rich people, go out of your comfort zone. Be with the poor. And where leaders are servant leaders, not lords, not dictators, but the old style of I am the parish priest and you must therefore obey me. No, you listen. As an only participant of the church, if you listen to everyone, to whom, to those who dissent, or to those who say yes, and especially to the poor farmers and the needy in your own parish. They must be part of that structural decision making. You must consistently rely on those who are educated and wise in the sense of learning. You can rely on the basic wisdom and common sense of ordinary people and of the poor. Make your pastoral councils a council for everybody and not only for mandated organizations. That is fine. But all this begins with a conversion. A conversion for all of us, that we have the attitude of Jesus the poor. And if you look at the life and message of Jesus the poor, he was God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And then go down further, and the Word came down and became and dwelt among us. And dwelt among us. And not only among us, everybody, but in a special way among the poor. Among the poor. He was born poor. That is Jesus. Born poor. Of royal lineage, according to the scriptures. But the only blood that Jesus had was not that of royal blood. He did not have the blood of Joseph that comes from the line of David. Jesus was prepared to be born of the Virgin Mary, bearing the blood of Mary, not of Jesus, but Joseph, conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit. But people knew him, thought of him, and acclaimed him as son of David. He was not. Yes, he is son of the Most High, but son who showed his sonship as God by becoming a servant. If you interpret the words, this is my beloved son in whom I will have peace. If you interpret those words,